Breaking the Wall of Inefficient Filters, Ankita Podel, Auckland University of Technology, New Zealand.
6 million people die due to air pollution every year. Every year. Back in my home country, I have experienced this pollution firsthand. It was so bad that if I was out for a few hours, I could feel the grit in my mouth, even after wearing a face mask. And it was crunchy. Imagine crunchy air. Now, my research is working towards designing filters to improve air quality. And I know making an efficient filter is tricky. If I want something that can capture everything, I'll have to build a thick filter by stacking many layers. But as a trade-off, it will block the airflow. Conversely, if filters are made less compact, they fail to trap particles. Well, they could trap some bigger particles, but the smaller ones just slip through. And when it comes to pollutants, those nano-sized ones are nastier, as they can penetrate deeper into our lungs, causing cancer, asthma, and heart diseases. So, does this mean we'll always have to compromise between a good flow and a good capture? Maybe not. To get the best of both, I tried to combine two technologies. One, using nanofibers. Now, if you look around your clothes, you might find a very thin piece of cotton fiber. Nanofibers are 100 times thinner than those fibers. And such fine fibers can form a mesh that is very breathable and has a large surface area. What does that mean? Just for perspective, why do we cut our vegetables? Because we want to increase the surface area. A larger surface area will increase the rate of cooking and allow for more spices and flavorings to attach, right? Now, with that advantage of nanofibers, I added my own spices in the form of coat technology. Based on special surface coating, I coated my nanofibers with chemical molecules that have special attractants. And guess what? Up to 92% of nanoparticles were removed even with a single layer of nanofiber. In fact, my coat-coated filters behaved like magnets, pulling the particles in as the air flowed through. And you can see here in this zoomed-in image how well the particles are sticking on the surface. And not only air, I've already extended my research to capture bacteria and viruses in water. So let's get ready to kick down that wall of inefficient filters and build this wall of protection that will help us breathe without having to compromise. Thank you.